my god, what? Pulsating mass of flesh and bone. A hideous agglomeration of flesh and bone. Limbs jut haphazardly from its mass. That sounds dangerous, like I'm gonna die soon. It sports a human head that gurgles out of sync with the pulsing of its other parts. Good god. This music. Machinery. This must be where diagnostics for experiments are reviewed. I'm just gonna save this as a separate game. I don't feel like this is a safe area, so I'm gonna trap myself. Scanning machinery. The scanner, pulsing with phosphorus light, awaits its next patient. Recent blood discharge. Hints that this life form isn't viable in the long term. Human host. The human appears... Well, there's a PDA, too. The human appears to be the host for the genetic hybrid growing out of it. Birth was clearly messy and painful.
Jeez.
Conjoined twin hybrids. Two bodies conjoined at the head share one brain. It doesn't seem that the brain is up to the task of coordinating movement between the two bodies. Good god. This guy must be the reincarnation of Dr. Mengele or something. Computer terminal. The console is dormant, awaiting input from the staff who will never return to work in this slaughterhouse. Another power cell. Overgrown hybrid. This appalling, distended creature appears to be a hybrid, although of what is unknown. It is not completely human. That much is absolutely certain. Scanning bays glow with an eager light. This readout tracks factors like equipment feedback and resistance thresholds. So, PDA. Scanning bays, yeah. Large infant skeleton. This is the skeleton of what must have been a very large infant.
What?
A standard looking human skeleton. Well, I can't really see that one very well. It's probably a good thing. Readout screens. Liquid nitrogen canister. Looks like we can take that. Test results flash across the screen. Preserve conjoined twins. The corpse of a creature hangs preserved. It may have been a twin. Two heads are fused together and a pale of spines meets. Each spine wraps around the other like a gnarled mountain range. Oh my god. Typical hospital screens used to protect the dignity of a patient. Oh, there's no dignity here. Terminals, three of them. Conjoined mass. One of the failed experiments, a lump of organs held together by wrinkled skin, bone pokes through the flesh in spots. Splayed open human body. Do medical schools ever feature bodies that so grossly exhibit their internal organs? I can answer that. Eviscerated corpse. In the aftermath of this body's evisceration, you can't tell whether its legs were removed or whether it ever had any. God. I'm not laughing because it's funny, I'm laughing because, oh my god, what? There's another PDA, readout screens. The screens are replete with analytical data about the subjects around you. Results of various tests, which you don't understand, flash across the screen in a blur. Okay, so we got two PDAs and a bunch of messed up crap. I guess read this. Okay, this is that one doctor we read about in the adjoining room over there. Or the room against the room across the hall. Dr. Clifford Backman. January 16th. They said I'd never make it to 60. Ha! 85, you bleep. This guy's 85 years old. Old and still cooking with gas. Yeah. Probably out of your butt. Three bastard kids and I outlived them all. Okay, so I was young when I had them. Those girls never even knew I was the father, of course. What? You look like you're bragging about this stuff. I had to switch the DNA sample so they didn't know their little shits were mine. I'm too old now for that, but you never completely lose your eye for ladies. Oh, God. I don't have a good opinion of this guy already, but it's like... going... plummeting even further, as if that's possible. February 28th. I might have false teeth, Dr. Mallon, but I'm no moron. For the good of humanity? I'm a sociopath. An alleged rapist of women? Can I kill this guy? Can I, like, turn him into one of these freaking eviscerated skeleton things? Eviscerated corpse? But your little speech to the crew was less sincere than anything I could say with a straight face. At least you know how to turn a blind eye whenever I have to get rid of troublesome subjects, right, Mallon? The new gas for the chambers is working splendidly, an improved kill rate of 60% on the old formula. I watch these poor bleepers writhe and die. We have a viewing window now, just so we can make sure it's done. Oh, yeah, the observation board or whatever. If I were a moral man, I'd call it perverse. It's lucky for Project Seed that I couldn't give a shit. I thrive when I don't have to answer to everyone with a conscience. What a stunning human being. March 17th. This will not do. Not at all. I need more subjects. The rejection ratio of the DNA splicing is stratospheric. So not only do I need more bodies, but I need better ones. They bring me imports and strays, but the best results are achieved with crew members. One cannot prey too often on those, of course, no matter the need. My chosen ones were always the ones, those who wouldn't be missed. The furnaces are inadequate for my disposal requirements. I'm told they're so hot they could destroy dark matter. They seem slow to respond when burning flesh, though, and the smell is hardly pleasant, either. It reminds me of that injured dog that I found as a little boy growing up in Missouri. Oh, boy, don't tell me. It looked at me with a pleading look, the kind of sick patient gives a doctor they trust absolutely. Naturally, I stomped on the mongrel's head. It was a mercy. There are too many in society who have a similarly damaged disposition. It's a kindness to snuff out their worthless lives. Okay, yeah, we found the reincarnation of Dr. Mengele, or the Angel of Death, whatever you want to call him. Well, I think that might be a separate person. I don't even know. Yeah, I'm not liking reading this. This is not fun to read. August 12th. I must get more pathway. That little prick DeSantos is usually... I know, I don't like it either. Just... chill out, though. Is usually more than forthcoming with its ingredients, but he says his own suppliers are having problems. I know you, DeSantos. I know you're not a real doctor. I know the kind. I have 5 PhDs and can tell when men have been hired for their instincts rather than their knowledge. Meanwhile, the cutting and splicing continues. Oh, and Charlotte, we all know about your little experiment, you stupid bitch. First she kills her partner by accidentally exposing him to a lethal virus, and then she goes gaga for him. What? That's the sort of beautiful incompetence that slays me. I spent years perfecting the art of the kill, making a murder appear a mishap, and she went and did it all completely by accident. What perfect nonsense. She accidentally exposed him to a lethal virus. Maybe we'll read about that on the other PDA? I don't know how she did that. October 10th. I held a subject down today and used my surgical hammer to cave in his windpipe. Then I gouged out his eyes and tried to rip his jaw from its socket. My goodness, what an outburst. I'm becoming careless. I need more pathway. What is pathway? Dr. Mallon is starting to worry that my tendencies cannot be controlled. You're not just a sociopath, you're a psychopath. He need not worry. I'm still focused on Seed. Seed is just that, a seed. But this chrysalis will soon break open and blossom. The successfully bred Homo novi wait in their containment cells, while their unsuccessful brethren, reduced to a viral mulch that's already breached the containment seals of the ship, grow. God. So that's what's going on with that. Okay, its genetic makeup might be a little more than trash, but it is astoundingly tenacious. I have to respect that which kills with such efficiency. It's pretty stupid. You know, you can get killed too. I woke up in the emergency room today, on November 12th. Somebody found me on the stairs. I can't remember much. What I do know is that both my legs are up in casts. I better get comfortable, because Dr. Graham says I'll be in here for at least a month. December 23rd. We die as the Novi cut us down, but I'm not ready to be replaced by a new species. Our creations are impressive, but I don't share Mylan's fanaticism for what is happening here. I must try to make one of the lifeboats available for me. Try to make sure one of the lifeboats is available for me. A shame there was not another for that delectable young thing. What was her name? Callister? Yeah, remember her, man, Callister. I would have liked to have her around when this ship was going to hell. She's dead, however. How unfortunate. Yeah, for her, not you. Excuse of human life form. January 3rd. Well, this is a really old entry. I mean, a new entry. Like, no, hardly anyone's writing entries in January. I may be old, but I'll tear anyone who tries to stop me from leaving apart at the limbs. That's an oddly constructed sentence. I have survived police investigations, court cases, vengeful spouses, and idealistic lab hands. I will gut any shitbag trying to prevent my escape. And that includes you, Mallon. I will jab out your eyeballs and eat them before I submit to you. Sure about that? You don't seem, you know, like you're holding back. You know, be honest.
Can you hear me? Do you know what, where you are?
Tech doesn't know. Alright, we're gonna check out all this stuff, I guess.
How can we allow this?
This is the purpose of the Groomlake.
What?
It's not on Earth. People can't see it, so they don't care.
But if they knew?
They don't even know, so they don't care.
So what?
Okay. Beginning to think I don't like you much either. You seem that it's... I mean, have you known all along? Are you one of the people involved in this?
If they were more open, this wouldn't happen.
Open to who? The people? Governments?
Other corporations?
What cost?
A bit of our humanity, I suppose.
That should not be up for debate.
It looks dead.
There's a skeleton there, I think. I got terminals, I'm gonna mess with those after. So I got another PDA somewhere.
Oh, stench. How long have they been here?
It's there. Down to now. 3 months? Probably longer, actually. 3 months is when everything went to hell. They were just doing this stuff for the whole while, I guess. Let's read this PDA. Dr. Marvin DeSantos. He mentioned DeSantos. What do you say about DeSantos? Before I read anything, he didn't like DeSantos because he doesn't like anybody. Alleged rapist of women? So he has not really rapist of women? DeSantos is usually more than forthcoming with its ingredients. His suppliers are having problems. He's not a real doctor, he says. So the pathway is his drugs? Antipsychotic meds, maybe? They don't seem to be working very well. Well, they started running out of them. These people don't have any emails. Okay, so it's a Santos. March 2nd. Man, that bitch from shipping won't get off my back. You bleep a girl real good and she just comes crawling back. If she doesn't get out of my hair, I'll have her moved off ship. Dr. Mallon is a prick, but he looks after me like that. I gotta say, being on Project Seed is awesome, man. Okay, so we gotta do some pretty noxious shit, but in exchange I get a lot of protection and an honorary title, Dr. DeSantos. I like it. Okay, so he actually really isn't a real doctor. I thought it was just Dr. Mallon's, you know, opinion. Or Dr. the other guy, opinion. PDA over there, whatever his name is, I forget already. Dr. Mallon knows about my contacts and private cargo that arrives on board, and I know he hates it, but there ain't nobody else prepared to work under Dr. Backman, that's his name. That guy is one twisted bleep, and also one of my best customers. I get imports, sure, but my own private lab is what manufactures Backman's pathway shit. Funny, I never realized how dependent these smartasses of science are on drugs. Personally, never touch the stuff. You gotta have your wits about you, man. Especially around here. May 15th. Wow. Dr. Williams. Charlotte. I never would have figured that uptight woman was a slut, but holy hell, she just gave me the ride of my life. Who'd have thought it? Slinky lace under that lab coat of hers, and for a woman in her mid-40s, a body that makes you want to get on your knees and howl at the moon. God, seriously. Against the table, pressed up against the viewport windows, on top, underneath, like a friggin' rattlesnake. Of course she's Looney Tunes. Probably thinks I'm her dead husband or something. Like I care, as long as she keeps coming to me to fulfill her needs. Crazy, but smart. And she has no idea how much I know about her little project. I saw the details. People just think I'm a smack-talking smartass, but I've been training on the Groomlake since I was 16. I studied chemistry and genetics, aced all of it too. She thinks I'm too stupid to understand. Wow, I like hate all of these people down here. September 9th. Thinking I could have gotten myself in too deep here. The drug thing was fine, but this whole industrial espionage thing is kind of freaky. I don't think Dr. Mallon knows. I know Lincoln watches me with an eagle eye, but he can't know for sure. If he did, he'd eject my ass from the ship with the rest of the failed hybrids. But goddamn, the money is good. I earned my year's salary by sending some info to Black Star Industries. My contact gave me more money than I could receive for leaking one report. One. I met the guy while I was on leave. He was a smug bleephead who somehow knew what I did. And then he flashed the cash. I've got no loyalties to the company, and I know how Dr. Mallon treats loyal staff. That guy can turn on a dime when it suits him. I've heard of weird shit going on down the decks below, and Seed has me feeling it'll soon be time to get the hell out of Dodge. Pronto. One or two more reports might just give me what I need. November 20th. Nobody knows about my little acts of espionage, but who'd care? This ship is falling apart. Some of those messed up things that Backman and Mallon made are on the prowl. I stashed away my cash as soon as I heard things were going wrong, but money ain't gonna make a spit's worth of difference if we all get killed. Mallon's taking all this way too calmly. Actually, I'd say he's enjoying all this. He came into the lab this morning. He still makes us all report to the lab, and was grinning the whole damn time, his eyes all red like he was coming down from a high. That guy does not need drugs for a high. His general messed upness is what he rides. And here was me thinking Backman was the crazy one. February 1st. Oh wow, this is a late entry. It's just us. Oh god. Not even Backman's around now. Charlotte was dragged away to the labs a few days ago. We're sealed off from the other decks. I reckon it's only a matter of time before Mallon decides to do something about me too. I've been living on this ship for years. I know about hidden passages that even Mallon doesn't know about. I'll get over to the communications array and let off a signal. Hopefully they'll get to us before Dr. Mallon finds out. I wonder if anyone will arrive, actually. I wonder if he did make it to the comm array. Or maybe that's our our, what do you call it, little, project, our goal is to do that, get to the comm array and let off a signal. So at February 1st, according to, as far as he knows, it was only DeSantos and Marlin left. Okay. So we got terminals. Oh. Mutagen Laboratory, Hybrid Reject 604, report by Dr. C. Williams, Charlotte Williams. During the autopsy of Hybrid 604, there were signs of renal failure. It appears the kidneys were unable to process the amino acids required for the breakdown of nutrients. The damage to the liver, stomach, and intestines show the same degenerative patterns. Reason: it is possible that the report of the mother giving birth 3 months prior was an error. Further reports regarding the failure of mutagenic compounds will be finalized later. Okay, this is the conjoined mass. Assuming. And this is a splayed open human body. Hybrid Reject 6, report by Dr. C. Bachman. Subject died during birth. It can only be surmised that death was due to a failing in the host, as all reports and tests leading up to the birth showed no signs of fetal defect. Upon further investigation of the woman's medical history, it was noted that she experienced complications when giving birth to a child previously. This host would not have been used had this been highlighted. In light of her medical history, I now assume this was the cause of the fetal distress and death of the subject. Note: host is being kept alive as undergone one transfusion. Recommendation: revoke host life support order and dispose of body with Hybrid Reject C. Nice, huh? And this is the eviscerated corpse, which we can't tell if it ever had legs or not. Hybrid Reject 811, report by Dr. G. Malin. A highly unusual form of rejection, such as has not been observed before manifested in this hybrid. It is entirely possible that the mutagenic compounds used to synthesize the hybrid DNA was faulty in this particular instance. Usually with any rejection there is sign of initial bonding and then a breakdown, but in this case there was absolutely no bonding attempted whatsoever. Given the thoroughness with which we create the DNA, I suspect that the centrifuge machine for this particular batch was faulty. Repair and a maintenance check of the machine is ordered immediately. Recommendation: destroy what remains and also destroy the fetus. The mutagenic compounds is faulty. No bonding attempt whatsoever. Centrifuge machine was faulty. Hmm. What is this? Slug gun operator's manual. I need that. I have a slug gun. Oh! Do I have to stand on one of these to use it? It looks like he's standing on one of those. You have to stand on a power cell. Anything else? Because I almost didn't notice the manual there. Seed? Something shooting something. Unlocked.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Well, I don't know what else to do. We have to take care of this robot somehow. It always stops and comes back after I save like that. Oh wait, this, I was gonna try to run into here, but that's above. We have to get to the elevator. I wonder if the defibrillator would work on it. Robot. The Void of Doom.
I think that will just break it.
I just have trouble picking this thing up. What if I put a defibrillator on the box and then shoot it with the slug gun? Ah, you can't shoot me back there. Oh god, we keep going back to this cutscene. That's annoying. So this must be it? This must be the containment area? Guessing that elevator brings us up here. So we need to take out the robot, get up the elevator platform. So this is just an idea.
These don't go well together.
No, huh? Yeah, that was a little nerve-wracking.
These don't go well together.
And that crate we can't select.
Probably not a good idea.
Yeah, right. Wash the bandages off? Oh, that works. Oh, what happened? I just got rid of it? The dirty bandage clogs up the steel drain of the sink. Okay. Gonna cause a leak. That would take out the robot. Zap. That's not it. We gotta do something else. Spilled water. Liquid from the overflowing sink is splashed onto the floor, pooling onto the polished floor. So wait. I hate to keep saving like this. I wish it would load my save instead of keep bringing me back to that section. Yeah, save. So if I take... the slug gun I don't think would do much. But if you throw the defibrillator on it, that would cause a static, not a static, an electrical charge, right? I just gotta wait till the robot's in it. Maybe when it turns around. Too late? I still have it. Awesome. I hope I don't die trying to walk on it. The sentry robot sits motionless as a wisp of smoke twirls from the burning CPU. Sweet.
Easy does it. God, just hate it. Click. Out. Got it.
Oh, what do I have? Got some goodies. Twisted metal. Nothing to say about the black void of doom? Oh, don't go there.
The oxygen atmosphere generating system is no longer functioning. Product failure is imminent.
Notice. Groomlake has experienced an electrical failure in the nuclear fusion fission hybrid engines.
Okay, I gotta figure out how to get past this lock. Maybe the power pad will have some use for that. A technology that provides an energy boost for heavy-duty equipment. Can I charge the twisted metal? Or maybe the defibrillator? We lost that, didn't we? Still have use. Yet to find a use for the slug gun. So that will be for next episode. I've been playing for quite a while, so four parts. This is the longest by far that I've been going, but I'm really, really enjoying it. I think I'm pretty sure our daughter's got to be beyond, and I don't have high hopes for her or my wife. I forget which one is Rebecca, but I think I'm looking for my daughter most of all. So, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.